started. So this is the interior of the wheel end. So the outside is stable, the inside can turn. It's lager, it's rust-free steel, so it can handle all the climate influences. And it can handle very high rotation speed, it can handle low rotation speed, it can handle vibrations. Washing machines have an asymmetric,
drum?
Yeah, moment. It can handle vibrations. So what we do is we strip the outside off, so the inside is going to be possible to attach the blades. But the blades I have the blades mm-hmm. replaced. So this is what you get then. Well, underneath here you have a gear with a belt, and here you see that this is normally the engine, but if you change the wires of the engine, you have a dynamo. If you're not satisfied with this dynamo, because it's not the most efficient dynamo, because you build it from an engine to a dynamo, you can use a car dynamo also. The gear is good because it gives you a high rotation speed on the dynamo, and that's what you need. You need to load actually good. Unfortunately, I cannot show you yet. You need a good speed on the dynamo to load the battery. Of course, you have loss because of friction, but it's better to have a loss of friction and a higher speed than to have a lower speed. And of course, it was also intended to make energy without it costing any money. That's what we tried to do. And it's going to succeed because it's a very stable structure. And it's a vertical wheel. Later at 6 o'clock, we drive to my home. I show you in the computer how it's going to look.
Then and where do you install it?
Just on top of the roof. If we go outside, start with the rain, so we have to be fast. So we have the flat roofs, or the capels of the roofs, like this house. And then you can install a piece, or you can put it on the pole. I think it's going to rain hard. That's basically
that's amazing.
A few words. So you just need a small garage or a shed in the back of your house. You just save your own old washing machine or get some of your friends or family. Sometimes they are on the street also. And the only thing you need is the interior.
We have some friends who would be interested in that, I'm sure. So
it's very accessible for everybody. You don't need money, you just pick one out, and when you strip it, you already have the most important and labor-intensive part of the mill. That's the axis, the lagers, the bearings, the transmission, and the dynamo. And you have this...
And you just have to rewire it.
Right? Yeah, you have to rewire it, and this depends on which mark, it's Miele or Bosch or some other in Dayslet, depends on which engine how you make the wire. So I'm now in the phase of collecting all the electric schedules. and then we can see how it's best to make the wires, because normally the engine uses several steps, from low speed or forward running or backwards running, and centrifuge, you don't need that anymore. So we have to have one speed that gives us electricity. So all the steps you normally have, you take out. All the cables of the washing machines we collect, we keep them, because we also going to use them. The exteriors of the washing machine we also going to keep, because we need to make protective coverage for the electric, for the dynamo. It's not ready, but the first one I'm going to build using an old fridge as a standard. And why we use an old fridge? Because there we can get the transformator inside and the sinus director and the fuse box. So it's well protected. And you don't have to invest any money, because an old fridge you can also find. So the blades we can make of any materials. Maybe later this day I'll make some blades.
That would be awesome.
And I have one here. We're going to strip. to show you how to strip it safe, because it, you need some to know how to strip it safe. Yeah. Because it, there's some danger, because it's all some, this metal is soft and polished, but there's some rough metal on the inside. So you, so you have to watch your wrists and you don't cut yourself. There's some safety issues in it. So this is step one, step two, step three. Step four is adjusting the blades. Step four is making from an old fridge, can be a long fridge too, you make the pole. So it's a very stable pole, and yeah, looks like a maybe crazy idea, but I couldn't find anything better. It's just a good fuse box too, you know. It's weather closed and moist or protected. What I'm going to do is add some roster here and above also for the air to go in and the air to go out, so we don't have the moisture that's going to stay in the box, of course. And that's it. You can basically put it on the roof then. I mean, we must make it stable, of course. And we have the mill for nothing.
Any predictions on how energy efficient it will be?
Yeah, I've checked the other mills, what they produce, and it's between 1,000 and 2,000 kilowatts a year. Okay. But I rather put the estimate down to 1,000.
Yes.
So, but that's... That's not so much, of course, because a house you need 3,500 a year kilowatts. But it's will be good for a lot of countries. For instance, we now are building these ones are going to Benin, Togo, and to Ghana in Africa. In Africa, they have a situation where they have people who have no electricity. So for them, it's the difference between having nothing. And have no lights, since 6 o'clock it's dark there, 6 or 7 o'clock. So if you have light there and you can put a frigo in it, and you can have your, I'll show you later the adapter I have, it's 12 volt, 220 volts on the outside and USB stick. So with the USB stick you can load your telephones and your laptop, everything. With the 12 volt you can use the 12 volt equipment, which you want to use, what you want. You can also, you don't have to use everything 220 volts. Sometimes it's cheaper and easy for those countries to have the 12 volt equipment. You don't have to transform the electricity again back to 220. And then we have, of course, the 220 volts. It's for the fridge. So an African house can have lightning, a fridge, and information. And that will change a lot, of course.
Yes.
You can get your food good, you can study at night, and you can get your laptop to study. So your children. We'll have a different future then. Huh? It's not hard to imagine. And there are 36 countries in Africa who need such things. The current electricity price or energy prices are too high in ratio to the brutto national products. So that's what we do now. That's why we do it, one of the reasons. And of course for ourselves. When we make one, we have to, this is not the most efficient model, it's about 1,000 kilowatts a year. But after that, we can build more efficient models. I've also designed some other models, but they will cost a little more for us. But it doesn't matter if this one brings for us some money, we can build the other ones. And this one will bring more electricity, about 2,000 kilowatts a year. And these mills, we can trade directly for electric vehicles, like electric scooters. Electric bicycles or electric motors, so that's good. So if you can have these workshops and you can build as many mills as you want, you build one for yourself or for your, and or maybe one or two for you and your family. You put them there and you build one or two extra. You can change them directly for vehicles, so you have them for free energy and electricity and mobility. Sorry. That's the goal. So that's the first two steps we're going to try to make this year. And that's the actual start of a resource-based economy, in this case with electricity. There are a lot of projects in Europe, of course, but this is what we try to do then. So.
And are you going to put it in the schematics and all the blueprints in open source?
Yeah, sure. Everything is open source. Not only the technique how to make a windmill, the whole concept. So if you, what we do is, it's still a little bit rubbish here, but what we do is I collect all the materials you need to build. all the technique you need to build and all the tools you need to build. And so this, when this place is finished, it will be a total blueprint of the whole concept, and it can all be copied. It's not just the technique. So if, for one instance, I now have collected some paint together with some members. So when we have enough paint to paint these mills, the paint that stays left can go to another friends of ours from our Zeitgeist movement, and they can use it also. If I have two or three times the same tools, like I collect a lot of hammers. we have several. Yeah. We have two. When I have enough of these materials, I donate them to the other workshops around. Mm-hmm. So we can easily learn, you know, in Europe, there's so much material lying in sheds and chambers on top of the house, you know, the roof chambers. It's unbelievable. But only those materials, when we use them, it's enough. It's everybody has something, you know. So we can make complete sets and copy it. Complete sets and copy it. Complete sets and copy it. What's the advantage? At the moment when we have many workshops all over Europe, or maybe if it's good, all over the world, finally, these workshops will stay. You can make any products you want there. So if somebody else has a better idea, says, oh yeah, the windmill is not so good, it's only 1,000 kilowatts here, I have an idea, it brings more energy. Or I have another idea, totally another idea, I don't know, something agricultural. Or you have the shop already.
Yes.
You have the shop. And you can start right away. So this concept is for us intended to start. To start something. Because we are, of course, we are like to tell people how we think about the world. But then after the movie, people started asking, like, what are you exactly doing then?
Yeah.
So this is an attempt for us to actually do something. And we're going to see what it brings. It's new. And there's no bosses in it. I'm not the boss of the place either. So I'm going to give the members the keys and everything that's going to build. And it's possible. I just want to show that it's possible to make energy without making profit necessarily, and without, you know, with an organization structure that has no bosses, also no hierarchy, because you don't need to. Hierarchy is a blockade for us. Without hierarchy, working is much more efficient for us, because they can collect each other's ideas and combine them into a good product that we need. And that's basically what you do. So that's the introduction.
And do you also, have you made any instructional videos on how to make that?
When it's finished, I'm going to, that's why later on I'm going to show you how to dismantle someone. It was first with safety instructions with it. And so this is step one, step two, later we all have step three and step four.
And how long does it take to make a whole
meal? When you have all the materials, about 2-3 hours.
2-3 hours.
Yeah, you can make easily.
So we could actually do a whole video about, you know, how to make it with us.
Yeah, that's good. But I don't have material for the blades yet, so I'll have to wait till the evening. So I go fix some other materials, because the blades can be made of virtually anything.
Mm-hmm.
You can make them of wood, you can make them of old scrap metal, you can make them of pipes with some plastic in between. So the blades is not a real big concern, but I had ordered some iron plates to make it look nice. Mm-hmm. I don't have them yet, but you can see the principle. It's very simple. This is all working. This is all you need, in fact.
Mm-hmm.
And you put this on a standard, stable, not with these new screws, and you cover it from the weather. And you put some blades. In Netherlands, we're going to build mills that are smaller than 2 meters by 2 meters, 2 meters diameter, 2 meters height, because you don't need to have the license from the government.
Okay.
And so each country will have its own, everybody will have its own mill, actually, because all our machines are different, so all mills will be a little bit different. And they are made by different people, so they automatically also will be different. Mm-hmm. That's why. So that's interesting, because from the difference comes the